Today, inshallah, we will study section 9.2 and finish chapter 9. But before that, we need to remember what we had in section 9.1 and finish the two remaining recitation exercises from 9.1. If you remember 9.1, it was about vectors in the coordinate plane in two dimensions. What you need to remember that the vector is a directed quantity that can be represented mathematically as an ordered pair, like here. So this is a vector. The A1 here, A1, it is the horizontal component, the X component. And A2 is the vertical component, the Y component. The magnitude or the length of a vector, it is just the square root of the sum of squares of the both components. When you multiply a vector by negative one, you will still have the same magnitude, but the direction will be reverse. It will be the opposite direction. How to find the direction of a vector? Just you can use tangent, the angle, or tangent, the direction is just the vertical component over the horizontal component, y over x. You can use also cosine and sine, which we obtained in the previous class. If you remember, cosine, the direction will be just the horizontal component over the magnitude. Also, sine theta will be A2 over the magnitude. You can also use this. If you have a vector V that is not a unit vector, you can make it a unit vector, a vector with magnitude one, just by dividing by the magnitude. You will have a new vector with magnitude one and with the same direction. The most well-known unit vectors are I and J in the two dimensions, of course. And any vector can be represented in three ways, in terms of I and J, or as an ordered pair, or in terms of the direction and the magnitude. How to add and subtract vectors, it is mentioned here, how to equate them. We solved this exercise in the previous class, how to find the K if you know that these two vectors have the same direction. Just if the directions are the same, then the tangent of the directions will be the same. And from that, we can obtain K. Also here, we solved this in the previous class. When you have a combination, a linear combination of two vectors, you can find the direction just by dividing the vertical component by the horizontal component, and then ask yourself, what is the tangent? What is the angle that its tangent equals to that? Let's practice more today by solving this exercise. So please, in your notebook, try to solve this exercise. You have here two vectors, U and W. Find a unit vector in the opposite direction of U. In the second part, we will have a question about W. Now think about U. Find a unit vector. A unit vector. What is the meaning of a unit vector? A vector with magnitude equals to one. And in the opposite direction of U. Let's pause the recording until you find an answer. Let's check the answer. The answer is negative square root of 5/5 I plus 2√5/5k, which can be, of course, written in, I saw some of you, they wrote it, of course, in terms of ordered pair like this. It's okay. It is true. But why I write it like that? Because I prefer always to have the output as the input. He gave me in terms of I and J, okay? So it is polite to return the answer in the same form of the question. This is the idea, okay? The idea, Shabab, is what? How to have a unit vector, how to get a unit vector from any vector. This is specified here. I mentioned this here in the summary. To get a unit vector with magnitude equals to one, just you need to divide by what? By the magnitude. If you bring any vector and you divide it by its magnitude, you will get a unit vector. Now, for the opposite direction, how to obtain opposite direction? Just multiply by negative one. You will get opposite direction. Please, Shabab, go to the summary, go to the section before going to solving the exercises. This is, of course, will help you to solve in the right way. And this is the solution. I think the idea now is clear. So we will, let's call it V. V will be negative U over its magnitude. You should have also like your brackets also. Now, this will be U, this is U. This is the negative. Then you multiply the negative to be negative 2i plus 4j over square root of 20, which is 2 square root of 5, simplify, then distribute, rationalize, and this is the final answer. Okay?
So now, doctor?
Yes, please.
We multiply by the negative to make them the opposite?
Yes. You can do it two steps. You can do it in two steps. Step one, multiply by negative. Next step, divide by the magnitude. And the answer will be the same. We did it here, 2 and 1. It works. If you didn't solve this, please try to solve this one. It is easier. Now the idea is clear. Find a vector of magnitude 2 in the direction of W. Forget about U. Look at W. You need now a vector of magnitude 2 in the direction of W. Again, I will pause the recording. The answer is square root of 2 and negative square root of 2. For those who prefer to use the brackets or the ordered pair notation, this is the answer. Again, you have a problem with simplifying your answers. Try to simplify it as much as possible. The idea is what? If you want to have it in the same direction, it is so easy. Okay? Don't change the sign. Okay? Here in this case, you should have it in the same direction. You should read this, what is written here. The vector V over the magnitude of V has a magnitude 1 and the same direction. So if you want to have the same direction with magnitude 1, divide by the magnitude. Now, if you want the magnitude to be 2, what you will do? This one, multiply by 2. So you will just multiply by 2. So this is exactly what we did here. Look. We assume that the new vector that we are looking for is this. W over the magnitude of W multiplied by 2. Now, this will give you at the end, if you look at it, you will get at the end a vector. The magnitude, if you calculate it, it will be 2. Try. Okay? And the direction will be the same. Because here, what is the direction here, Shabab? What is tan theta W? It will be negative 3 over 3, which is negative. Here, the same. Tan theta V, the new vector, will be also negative 1. The same direction, the same tangent, the same angle. Okay, yes.
I solved it with another way.
What is it?
By finding the theta. Then I use the magnitude multiplied by cosine theta and the magnitude multiplied by sine theta.
And you find the magnitude to be 2. You wrote it to be 2. Good idea. His idea is also good, Shabab. From here, he obtained theta. Okay? Then he used the new vector will be what? The magnitude, which is 2, cosine theta. And this will be 2 sine theta. And you have theta. What is it?
7 by 4.
Theta is what?
7 pi over
4. 7 pi over 4 theta, 7 pi over 4. Cosine 7 pi over 4. And you can continue. The same answer will be at the end. All right. Excellent. Now I think it is time to say goodbye for 9.1. It is enough. We practiced, we solved like 4 questions from the recitation exercises. There are a few old exam questions about 9.1, so I will let you practice them by yourself. Now, 9.2 is about an operation that we didn't mention in 9.1. In 9.1, we mentioned how to add and how to subtract, vectors. Also, how to multiply a vector by a number. Now we will see how to multiply two vectors. We will see also, is the result a vector or not a vector? There are two types of products for vectors, the dot product, the inner product, or the cross product that you will study later. Only here we will mention the dot product. Also, we will see how to find the angle between, how to define first, how to define the angle between two vectors and how to evaluate it, how to find it. And finally, we will see together what are the orthogonal vectors. First of all, there is a well-known theorem that's called the dot product theorem, from which we obtain this kind of product. We will see it in the next slides, but let's define first what is it. If you have a vector u and another vector b, v, the components here are a1 and a2, here b1 and b2. Then the dot product of these two vectors will be defined by this definition. U dot v equals to a1 b1 plus a2 b2. What is that? This is just the first component with the first component, the second component with the second component, then add the product of them. It is the sum of the product of the components, the corresponding components. And you know, this is a real number, this is a real number, the product of them is a real number. Real number plus a real number will be a real number. So the dot product is not a vector. The product, if you use the dot product for two vectors, it will not be a vector, it will be a real number, not a vector. While the cross product that you will study later, it is in chapter 8, in chapter 9, by the way, if you are interested in this, you can look at your textbook. It is for three, when you have three dimensions and more, you can have other kinds of products. We will see from this, from where this dot product is coming when we study the angle between two vectors. If this is u, this is v, what is u dot v? It is 2. It is just 3 times 4 plus negative 2 times 5. 12 minus 10, which is 2. What about these two vectors? 2i plus j, 5i minus 6j. It will be 4. It will be 2 times 5 plus 1 times negative 2 equals negative 6 equals 4. Excellent. The properties of the dot product, the first property says that they are commutative. The dot product is commutative. U dot V is the same as V dot U. It is also associative with the scalar multiplication. It is distributive. And most importantly, that if you multiply a vector by itself by using the dot product, the result will be the square of the magnitude. Why is that? You know, ya shabab, what is the magnitude, right? If you have a vector u, let's say that we have a and b. What is the magnitude? Square root of a squared plus b squared. Now, what will be u dot u?
A squared plus b squared.
It will be a and b multiplied by a and b again. What is it?
A
times a squared plus b squared. What is this? This is the same as this one, but what? Squared. So this is exactly what we have here. Now it is time to ask yourself how to find or evaluate the angle between two vectors. If you have a vector u and another vector v, of course, these two vectors will form an angle. Between them, there will be an angle. How to evaluate it? How to find it? Is it related also to the direction of V and U? How to evaluate it? In fact, it is related to the dot product. And from here, in fact, the dot product appears. We have here what is called the dot product theorem. Okay. Let me make it scratch for you from the beginning. If you have two vectors u and let's say this is another vector v, Now the angle between them, is it this one or this one? Is it alpha one or alpha two? Why? So we should agree, because both of them, both are angles, the sides of these two angles are the two vectors. We will consider the angle between two vectors to be the smaller one. Okay, so this is the angle between them. So the angle between, the angle theta between two vectors u and v is the smaller of the angles formed by u and v. Because of that, who can tell me what is the maximum and the minimum values of this angle? This angle will be for sure greater than or equal what? If it is zero, they will be identical. They will be overlapping each other, okay? Now, what is the maximum? It will be less than or equals what? 180 degrees. Why? Why it is, why it cannot go to 360? If we have, for example, an angle that is here and a vector that is here, which will be the angle, let's call this W. What will be the angle between U and W? Is it this one or this one? The smaller one, right? It will be this one. And of course, it cannot be greater than pi. It cannot be greater than 100. If it crossed 100, if this is U and this is, let's say, the another vector V, if it is like that, and now it, if it becomes here, I will not take this one. I will take the smaller one. So always it will be less than 180 degrees. So remember this, that the angle between two vectors, it is always greater than or equal zero, less than or equals what? Pi. Which means, in other words, if you are thinking about sine, cosine, tangent, it is in the first quadrant or the second, okay? The value of it, not the terminal side of one of the vectors. Now, as I told you that the angle between two vectors can be found in terms of the dot product and the magnitudes of these two vectors. If you did here cross multiply, you will have this u dot v. This is another definition for u dot v. Look, u dot v will be the magnitude of u multiplied by the magnitude of v cosine theta. If you are interested in the proof, it is in your textbook in page 676. It depends on the law of cosine. Do you remember the law of cosine from the high school? It is very important law, by the way. I don't know why they exclude it from this course. I think it is in chapter 8. It is in chapter 8. The law of cosine, Shabab, it is the generalization of the Pythagorean theorem. You remember the Pythagorean theorem? The Pythagorean theorem says that if you have a right triangle, if this is C, this is A, this is B, what is the relationship between these three sides? A squared plus B squared equals to what? C squared. Now, if it is any triangle, if it is not a right triangle, what will be the relationship between the sides? In fact, let's call this angle theta. Now, there is a relationship between the sides of the triangle, any triangle, not necessarily right triangle. And this is exactly what is called the law of cosine. Who can tell me what is it? Yes, please. C squared equals to A squared plus B squared minus 2AB cosine theta. This is the law of cosine. I think you will use it maybe in math 101, math 102. So important one. Now this one, it is special case. The Pythagorean theorem, it will be just a special case when theta equals to what?
90
degrees by over two. Because if this is 90 degrees, this will be what? Zero, and you will have, of course, this one. C squared equals to A squared plus B squared. Now, from this law, we obtain this formula. If you are interested, it is in your textbook. It is a very interesting one. Okay, now, what we need to remember from this slide, Shabab, how to find the angle between two vectors, you need to find the cosine of this angle first. cosine this angle equals to the dot product divided by the product of the lengths of these two vectors. Also, if you have the lengths of these two vectors and the magnitude and the angle between them, you can find the dot product by using the dot product theorem. Example, two vectors, 2 and 5, 4 and negative 3. What is the angle between them? How to find it? We will start with what? Cosine theta. Cosine theta equals to u dot v over magnitude u magnitude v. What is u dot v? 2 by 4, 5 by negative 3. Over the magnitude of u, the magnitude of v, negative 7 over 5 square root of 29. Is it a well-known angle? It is not. So how to represent it? How to write it? Theta is cosine inverse this. Which is, if you set your calculator in degrees, you will get 105 degrees, 1.1. If you set in radians, you will get, of course, the angle in radians. It is up to you as you want. Let's take an angle that is well known. We can evaluate without a calculator. Find the angle between these two vectors. Find it, inshallah. Can you? What is it? What is u dot v? So it will be 0 over whatever, 0. So cosine theta is 0. What is theta? This is 90 degrees pi over 2, right? So here we have cosine theta u dot v. We will find that it is 0. Don't waste your time calculating this because it will be 0 over a number. It will be 0. What we can say about these two vectors that the angle between them is 90 degrees? When you have, again? Perpendicular. They are perpendicular to each other. Or in other terminologies, they call them orthogonal. Orthogonal vectors are perpendicular vectors. Two non-zero vectors are perpendicular or orthogonal if the angle between them is pi over 2. Now, we have a very nice criteria to determine if two vectors, it is not easy to measure if I give you two vectors and you need to find that the angle between them is. But you can find the dot product. You remember from the dot product theorem that u dot v, it is the absolute value of the length of u multiplied by the magnitude of v cosine theta. Now, if theta is pi over 2, what will happen? This will be 0, right? So the dot product will be what? 0. And here we have a very, very interesting theorem that says that two non-zero vectors, u and v, are perpendicular if and only if their dot product is. So if the dot product is 0, they are perpendicular. If they are perpendicular, the dot product is 0. It is a double conclusion here. This is the proof. This is exactly what I told you, Shabab, about the proof. If they are perpendicular, the angle between them is pi over 2, and then the dot product will be 0. Now, if the dot product is 0, then this will be 0. This is with theta. This will be 0. This is not 0. This is not 0 because this is the magnitude. So cosine theta will be 0, then theta is pi over 2. You can now determine whether the vectors are perpendicular or not. For example, these two vectors, perpendicular or not?
No.
How to know? Find the dot product. If the dot product not 0, they are not orthogonal. They are not perpendicular. But if the dot product like the other two in part B, then they are what?
Orthogonal
or perpendicular. That's it. This is 9.2. We are done with this section. Remember that the most important thing that we need to know from this section, first of all, what is the dot product of two vectors? What are the properties of the dot product? And how to find the angle between two vectors, and you should remember that it is always between 0 and pi. And also, you can have it in another way. This is another way to find the dot product. Look, this is one form, this is another form. to find the dot product. And finally, the orthogonal vectors. They are vectors with dot product equals to zero. I believe now you can solve this recitation exercise, please. So easy one. You have here two vectors, two orthogonal vectors. Then what is K? Or what is the sum of all the values of K for which these two vectors are orthogonal? The answer is C. Let's see why it is C. In fact, here, what you need to do is to write the two vectors in terms of I and J or in terms of ordered pairs. It is up to you. So I prefer to have it in this form. Is it okay for you?
Yes.
So this is K and negative one. So what will be this?
K minus two.
Look here, I and I. So it will be K minus two and what? And three. So this is the vector U. Now you want to find what? He said that they are orthogonal. So the dot product U dot V or V dot U, it is what? Zero, because it is commutative, the dot product. So here we are. This is what we will do. This is U. Now U dot V will be zero. So this K multiplied by K minus two plus negative one multiplied by three will be zero. Now it is an equation, a quadratic equation. You can stop here, by the way, because he is asking about what? The sum. And you know that the sum will be negative B over A. It will be negative two over one, which is two. But it is, of course, better to continue because maybe some solutions will be rejected. They are not, for some reasons, they might be rejected, but not in this specific exercise. Factor, then you will get K equals three or K equals negative one. Their sum is two. Clear? Okay, if it is clear, you can solve this question. This is the last recitation exercises. We will practice more, inshallah, by solving at least two old exam questions. The last recitation exercise is about what? About the angle between two vectors. If theta is the angle between two vectors, V and W, then find sine 2 theta. Where theta between 0 and 2 pi. No need to give you this. Why? It is by default, ya shabab. This is an additional information that is not needed. Even if he didn't mention this, you should know that theta between 0 and pi. Because always the angle between two vectors will be always between 0 and pi. What is sine 2 theta? Okay, let's go back. The answer is negative 24 over 25. This is the value of sine 2 theta. What is the idea? You need to find what? The angle between two vectors. You have the formula. The formula says what? That cosine theta is the angle between them, will be V dot W over the magnitude of V multiplied by the magnitude of W. So this is the dot product, this is the magnitude of V, this is the magnitude of W. Now just, it is a matter of simplification. You obtain this at the end, negative four over five. This is what now? This is cosine theta, negative four over five. Now theta between zero and pi. So this means that theta in the second quadrant. So you will draw a triangle in the second quadrant. This is negative four over five. This will be three by the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, is that right? This is not right. This is not correct, Yashabab. Of course, not correct. Here we have negative four over five. This will be three. There's a mistake here. Okay, so now this will be three, this will be five. Now, this is our, of course, our angle, theta. And in that case, sine will be three over five. And sine to theta will be two sine theta cosine theta. Is negative 24 over 25. Okay, let's solve this old exam question. Please try to solve this old exam question. It is a final exam question because it is about two or three sections in one question. So it is very nice to have a question that can be considered as multi-concept question. It's so easy also. By the way, if you say the half, you were very close from the right answer. The answer is negative half, not half. You forget about the negative sign. I know from where this these kind of mistakes are coming. Now, guys, u dot v will be equals to what? The first component with the first component, the second component with the second component. So it will be what? Sine 40 degrees, cosine 70 degrees, plus the second component, cosine 40 degrees multiplied by the second, which is negative cosine 20 degrees. So it is better to write this negative here. Do you mind? If I write it here, just minus, and this will be just cosine 20 degrees. Which formula is this? No, it is not. Not yet. Because you know that if it is sine, it will be sine, cosine, cosine, sine. Or it is cosine, cosine, sine, sine. It is up to you now. What do you want to use? The addition or subtraction formula for sine or for cosine? I think, yeah, Shabab, it's okay. Like look here. You have here sine 40, cosine 40, right? And this is cosine 70. I wish that this is sine 70. So we can. It is. By what? By the cofunction identities. Here it is. Now it is what? Sine what? 40 minus 70 or 70 minus 40? How to know? Because here it make difference. It make difference here, Shabab, because sine is odd. It is not like cosine. If it is cosine, it doesn't matter. You need to remember the formula. Who can remind me about the formula? Sine alpha minus beta equals to what?
Sine alpha.
Sine, the positive one. Sine alpha, cosine, the negative one, the one that we subtracted, not the negative one, minus cosine alpha sine beta. So look here, what comes first, ya shabab? It comes here with sine. What comes next? It comes with sine here. So this is how to make it. Now you can solve it. For sure, you will be able to say that this is equals to sine what? Negative 30 degrees, which is negative sine 30 degrees, which is what?
Negative
a half. Now, please also solve this one. It is so easy and it will not take, I think, more than 1 minute from your time. This is another old exam question. He gave you the angle between the two vectors. He gave you the magnitudes. He wants the product. If you have an answer, raise your hand.
Excellent, Muhammad. New face day, Aziz. Excellent. Yes, Aziz Sufiani. This is enough, Shabab. It's okay. The answer is Abdul Aziz Sufiani. What is your serial number, Abdul Aziz?
22. Excellent, ya Shabab. So the answer is negative 10. It is so easy. You know that cosine alpha will be equals to negative 2 square root of 5, right? From the definition of the cosine inverse. Now you know that U dot V equals the magnitude of U times the magnitude of V cosine alpha. This is from the dot product theorem. Now square the magnitude of U is 5. The magnitude of V is square root of 5. Cosine alpha is negative 2 over square root of 5. This is, of course, will be cancelled with this, and you will have negative 2 multiplied by 5. It is negative 10. This is the dot product. This is all what we have in chapter 9. Next class, inshallah, we will move to chapter 10.